Richard Twardzik was born in Boston in 1931. His father designed stained glass windows and his mother was an illustrator. Dick was drawn to art, but he also displayed prodigious musical talents and by his early teens was giving classical recitals. Luckily for jazz, one of Dick's piano teachers was the mother of legendary baritone saxophonist Serge Shaloff. Serge and Dick began playing together and the pianist was soon hooked on bebop.
It was just after World War II, as I recall.
Composer, teacher, and musicologist Bob Zief.
There was a club in my hometown that had Sunday afternoon jazz sessions. And he came in with his father. He was about 14, I think, something like that. And he kind of leaped right in, and he was playing Bud Powell and Tad Dameron voicings and figurations like Bud and Bird and so forth, and much to the apoplexy of all the musicians around, you know, who was this young kid and what was he doing in such a hurry? Anyhow, we met a little while later on, and he asked me about lessons, and so we started in, and he wanted me to help him analyze Chopin piano pieces and things about my own theory and so forth and so on. He was like a vacuum, of course, because he was so intelligent musically that he picked up on things, you know, in an instant. You didn't have to tell him anything twice. You had to tell him it about a half of a time. About jazz history or anything else. I mean, he was appreciative of it and aware of it to a good extent, and a lot of other things. And I think he used whatever was there. It was whatever Dick Twardzik was carrying around with him in his mental musical collection.
Can really hear, particularly harmonically, the kind of stuff that he'd been listening to in European music. But at the same time, he was one of the earliest pianists to latch onto Monk, because there's quite a lot of stuff he plays, again harmonically, which is quite angular.
By his late teens, Twardzik was a well-established part of a burgeoning Boston scene that also boasted pianists Jackie Byard and Cecil Taylor. But it wasn't until 1951, when he turned 20, that Twardzik first entered a recording studio. The band leader, with the sense to invite him, was alto saxophonist Charlie Mariano.
I remember, like, that there was a buzz around about this new, young pianist, like, who was, you know, really something else, and that was Dick Twardzik. He was like farther ahead than most everybody else. You know, we were like, because this was about the time, like, when bebop was like really coming on very strongly. And Dick was, you know, taking it like a step further. That's why I was using him, because he was like one of the best around.
Charlie Mariano's Boston All-Stars, recorded in 1951. With the help of Mariano and Serge Shaloff, Dick Twardzik's profile was steadily increasing, but he was still a relative unknown outside his hometown. However, in 1952, everything changed. Dick was invited to sit in with a visiting quartet at Boston's premier club, the Hi-Hat. With Roy Haynes on drums, Charlie Mingus on bass, and the legendary Charlie Parker out front, Twardzik found himself on stage with the gods of bebop. After the first night, Parker asked him to play for the whole week. By 1953, Twardzik was performing regularly beyond Boston city limits. One night, playing with his own group, he was spotted by Russ Freeman, the high-profile pianist with the Chet Baker Quartet. Freeman was so impressed with Twardzik that he secured him a trio session with the Pacific Jazz label. Chet Baker dropped by the studio and was so blown away that he ended up hiring Twardzik for an extensive European tour.
Dick Twardzik said, I'm working with Chet Baker now, and we're going to Paris, and we're going to record. He said, give me everything of yours, and we'll record it.
Unable to resist such an offer, Bob Zeef did as Dick requested, sending seven compositions that were both highly original and fiendishly difficult.
Before Dick left, he had me coach him through all the pieces. So I would guess that he ran the record date. You know, Chet did wonderfully on those things, as few other people in the world could have done.